Hello everybody, Bum Chef is back, and as you can see, I've brought 50,000 pounds of meat with me, and we are gonna roast it today! Okay, this is not 50,000 pounds, but 3 pounds, almost the same. This is a Kassel or Kassler in German, pork meat from the shoulder, and it's pre-salted to make it last longer. You could eat it as it is, but we're gonna roast it. Because of the seasoning salt, all we now need is garlic. For this we slice it about just 8 slices, just the tip of the knife. How much was that now? Okay, now we have some holes, and we season it only with garlic, as I mentioned. And this is really not a complicated dish. It's pretty fast and easy, straightforward. And just cut it once. Okay, these are pretty big sprouts of garlic, we cut it twice. So what you want to get in the end are this, like, lengthy garlic pieces. Okay, and then we stick those into the holes we made before. Try to put them deep inside. If they don't fit, you have to cut deeper, but they have to vanish completely. And I have to warn you, don't eat this when you are in a business with a lot of customers. They will run away and never come back. The smell is strong with this one. Okay, and we take a pan, just like this, nothing special. Add some sunflower oil, not too much, just a puddle like this. And that's all you need. A simple, fast and easy roast. We put it in the oven at 180 degrees Celsius for at least 1 hour. In the meantime, we will handle the side dish, which are red and yellow bell peppers. There are many ways to cut them. What I do is half them, as you can see, from up to down, and just use your fingers to break this out. This way you get like 80% of everything that needs to go. The rest, also use your fingers. Pretty easy to clean. Okay, the last two or three seeds that are still in there, we will wash them up or down, wash them down. Okay, people also tend to make it a true science how to cut them. I join the club and present my own science. I cut this, the upper end, down, the lower end, and squeeze it down. This is at least how Bum Chef tells you to cut those bell peppers. Now we wait until the roast is about 30 minutes in the oven, and I show you what's coming up then. And now you have to be strong. You have to act like a grown-up and decide for yourself what to do next. We have to add some liquid. We have four possibilities: plain water, consommé, pork or chicken, whatever, beef or consommé, not, it's a matter of taste, or red wine or white wine. The important thing with the wines is don't take half dry or sweet or tasting like sunflowers on a summer evening. All this, those tastes of sweet and half dry, in the end they will taste burnt. Just burnt. You don't want burnt. You want a taste of wine. So you take dry wine. Totally dry as dust. Red or white, consommé, water, it's a matter of your personal taste. I, for my taste, now take white wine and just pour it all over the roast. The one I chose, if you're interested, is Blanché. I highly recommend it. It's almost made just for cooking. Of course you can drink it, but it's made for cooking. And I preferred, on another day I would have taken red wine or consommé, water, not most likely. I will add the rest. For meat this big, those are, as I said, 1.5 kilograms, 3 pounds. Those are a quarter liter. Now it goes back into the oven. We reduce the temperature to 150 degrees. I redecided, I rethought my time. This big chunk of meat should be from now on another full hour. Let me tell you one thing. A cook, a chef, a real chef, doesn't measure time with a clock. We measure time in colors. When the roast is deeply brown, it's ready. You could also take a thermometer and just measure how hot it is. It's another possibility. But then you have to learn all those temperatures.
Pork has to have this temperature, then it's ready. Beef has this temperature, then it's ready. Chicken,
ready. Whatever. Deeply brown is ready. Simple. And I think it's 1 hour, but I will take a look at it. And if it's not enough, I left it in there for another 10 minutes. Simple as that. And we're back. More than an hour has passed, but not really more, just 2-3 minutes. I've taken a look at the castle and it's looking really good. This is how you want it to look. A deep red brown, as you can see. The garlic has come up and is slightly black, but that's totally okay. That's what we want. And you can see the liquid is almost totally gone. There is liquid left, but it's not much. Okay, now we take it out of this pan, put it on a plate, and surprise, it comes back into the oven, but only at about 70 degrees. We just want to keep it warm at this point, because we need the rest of the liquid and the pan. We add the saltish, the bell peppers, and sour cream. Mix it up. And of course we take the rest liquid of the roast with it. It's not just the white wine, it's also all the juices that came out of the castle. Okay, now for the seasoning. We add some salt, but be really careful. As I said, the castle is covered in salt. It's it has enough, but all the pepper and the sour cream is rather soft in taste, so we need a bit salt, not too much. Then I have mixed pepper, all kind of colors, red, white, and it's broken. This is what you get when you get all your equipment out of trash bins. Life as a bum chef is not easy. Look at this. I've also found behind some restaurant in the trash bin some chili strings. Those are basically dried chilies which are cut into strings. I don't know how they do it, but they did. Looks like hair from some kind of wolverine. I wonder how this tastes. You'll probably see this in another episode. Mix it again. So we add a top of this for this and put it up on the oven. Half of the possible maximum heat, half heat, and let it cook for at least 30 minutes. A short update, as you can see it's boiling like crazy. This is because I increased the temperature. I had to. There you see the boiling. It didn't really started to become forward, so I increased the temperature. It's now on full high heat, but I will decrease it as soon as the liquid has become less. Okay, Bum Chef is back once more. Now we taste everything. As you can see, almost all the liquid has vanished. The bell peppers have sucked up almost every drop of the sour cream. And this is just what you wanted. And of course, a big slice of meat. And there you go. Of course, we could add rice. I would suggest rice if you want even more side dish. Potatoes, not so good for this dish, I think. But I will eat it without rice and potatoes or anything alike. It's perfect. The meat is tender but juicy. And so are the bell peppers. They have an intense taste of the white wine we added. And it's just good. And remember, if you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.